I sat in the back of the car with the box beside me as the driver tore through the streets of Basra like a ricocheting bullet. I sat in the back side of the car, which means I was not driving the car. With the box beside me, I had a box beside me in the back side of the car. As the driver tore through the streets, as the driver was driving the car very fast through the streets of Basra city like a ricocheting bullet. Here the writer has compared the speed of the car with a ricocheting bullet. Actually, he has exaggerated the speed of the car. He wants to say that the speed of the car is as much as the speed of a ricocheting bullet. The aircraft was waiting to take off. When I reached at the airport, the aircraft was waiting to take off. I was rushed through to it by infuriated officials. Here I mean by rushed through is dealt quickly and sent. I was dealt quickly and sent to the plane by the infuriated, by the angry officials. The officers were angry because I was late for the flight. Luckily, the seat booked for me was at the extreme front. Fortunately, the seat I booked was at the extreme front. I covered the floor around my feet with newspaper, rang for the air hostess and gave her a parcel of fish to keep in a cool place. I covered the floor around my feet. As soon as I reached inside the aircraft, I covered the floor around my feet with newspapers to keep water there, and I rang for air hostess. I blew the ring to call air hostess. When she came, I handed her over. I gave her a parcel of fish which I had brought for Ms. to keep it in a cool place so that it does not get rotten. I took her into my confidence about the events of the last half hour. I shared my event with her of last half an hour. I have retained the most profound admiration for the air hostess. The strongest appreciation for the air hostess in my heart. The reason behind, she was the very queen of her kind. She was the true queen of her type. She suggested that I might prefer to have my pet on my knee. Her suggestion was I was allowed to keep otter on my knees instead keeping it around my feet on the floor. And I could have kissed her hand in the depth of my gratitude. I was feeling so deep grateful to her that I wanted to kiss her hands. But not knowing otters, as I did not know much about otters at that time, I was quite unprepared for what followed. What happened next, I had not expected. Miz was out of the box in a flash. In a very short time, in a flash, Miz got out of the box, as there was no lid on the box. He just disappeared at the high speed down the aircraft. He got disappeared in the plane at a very high speed. There were squeaks and shrieks. Squeaks and shrieks means cries. There were cries in the aeroplane, and a woman stood up on her seat screaming out. Exactly when Miss Bill got out of the box and disappeared in the plane, A lady started shouting. A lady started screaming. Rate, rate. I caught sight of Miss Stelling disappearing beneath the legs of a portly white turbaned Indian. I saw Miss Bill's tail disappearing. I saw Miss Bill's tail disappearing beneath the legs of a portly, of a fat, white turbaned Indian. Where did the tail of Miss Bill get disappear is beneath the legs of a fat, white turbaned Indian. Diving for it. When I dived to catch Miss Bill, I missed. I couldn't catch. But found my face covered in curry. While diving for Miss Bill, I got my face covered with curry. Perhaps, said the air hostess with most charming smile. With a very beautiful smile, the air hostess said, perhaps, probably, it would be better if you resumed your seat and I will find the animal and bring it to you. The air hostess, who was the queen of her type, suggested that probably the rider should have stayed on his seat and she would bring the otter back to him. I returned to my seat. I came back to my seat. I was craning my neck, trying to follow the hunt, when suddenly I heard from my feet a distressed chitter of recognition and welcome. I was extending my neck in order to seek my hunt. And my hunt was Miss Bill. I was stretching my neck. Suddenly, when I was craning my neck, I heard something. And that something was chitter of recognition and welcome. A chitter which was familiar to me and showing that it recognized me, it welcomed me. And I saw that Miss bounded on my knee. Miss climbed quickly on my knees and began to nuzzle my face and neck and started to rub itself with my face and my... Miss and I remained in London for nearly a month. We remained in London for almost a month. He would play for hours with a selection of toys, ping pong balls, marbles, rubber fruit, and a terrapin shell that I had brought back from his native marshes. Miss Bill would play for hours with a selection of toys, with selected toys, and ping pong balls, marbles, rubber fruit, and a terrapin shell. The terrapin shell had been brought from his native marshes, which is Tigris marshes. With the ping pong ball, he invented a game of his own which could keep him engrossed for up to half an hour at a time. With the ping pong ball he invented a game, and this game could keep him engrossed, could keep him engaged for half an hour at a time. A suitcase that I had taken to Iraq had become damaged on the journey home. I had taken a suitcase with me when traveling to Iraq, and on the way back to home, back to Europe, it got damaged somehow. So that the lid, when closed, remained at a slope from one end to other. This suitcase got damaged in such a way that when the suitcase was closed, its lid Its cover remained on a slope from one end to another. The suitcase lid remained on a slope. Miz invented that if he placed the ball on the high end, it would run down to the length of the suitcase. Miz discovered that if he placed the ping pong ball on the higher end of the suitcase, the ball would run down to the lower corner of the suitcase. He would dash around to the other end. After putting the ping pong ball on the higher end, he would run around to the other end, to the lower end, to ambush its arrival. To attack the arrival of the ball, he would stop the ball, crouching. He would crouch down to spring up. He would run to the another corner, to the lower corner of the suitcase, and would bend down to spring up and take the ball by surprise. Surprisingly, he will take the ball, he will grab it, he will catch it and trot off with it, and he will leave for the higher corner of the suitcase. Outside the house, I exercised him on a lead precisely as if he had been a dog. Outside the house, I made him exercise on a lead exactly as if it were a dog. Miz quickly developed certain compulsive habits on these walks. On these walks with me, Miz developed some compulsive habits which were impossible to stop. Like the rituals of children, like the customs of children, who they're on the way to school and back to home, must place their feet squarely on the center of each paving block. Students who on their way to school and back to home put their feet squarely on the pavement block. And they must touch every seventh upright of the iron railing. They would definitely touch the vertical point of the iron railing or pass to the outside of every second lamppost or take turn to the outside of the every second lamppost. These are the rituals of children. Opposite to my flat, in front of my flat, there was a single-storied primary school, a school which has a single-story building along whose frontage ran a low wall some 2 feet high. Exactly in front of my flat, there was a single-storied school. And along the frontage of the school building, there was a 2 feet high wall. On the way home, but never on his way out, on the way home, when I and Miz were supposed to return home, Miz would tug me to the wall, Miz would pull me to the wall and jump on to it. He will jump on the wall and gallop the full length of its 30 yards. And he would run to the 30 feet length of the wall, to the hopeless destruction both of people and staff within. He would, even if it disturbs both staff members and pupils, he would do so. He would run to the 30 feet length of the wall. 30 yards length of the wall he would